Hey everybody, DSJ here. I never thought I'd do a random play on this, especially something I haven't played in so long. As you could tell, I'm about to do a random play of Final Fantasy VIII. Yes, this is the Steam release. Let me go ahead and make another save file. Because the first save file, I'm gonna play seriously. This one, I'm just gonna show y'all just play. I'm not gonna lie, I do like the stuff they did on the Steam release. Like some of the boosters, like money. Damage at 9,999. Constantly on limit break. Stuff like that, it's not that bad. But here's the one thing I thought I never had to do. Because I'm not the person that usually uses mods. But, ugh. There was one mod I had to do. And that was the music. No. Skip. I know how to junction. Thank you. Yes, I already know. Alright. But yeah, if you download the Steam release, here's the issue I have with the Steam release. It's not the game itself, but the music. MIDI, really? I'm not gonna lie. When I first heard the MIDI files, it was horrible. The map music was horrible, and the battle music, I was like, what the hell was I listening to? This is not the music from the game I remember. And then I tried to, you know, do the Roses and Wine mod. You know, with the orchestra, with one of the earlier versions, and it didn't work. And that's the one that actually included the orchestrated track, which I could care less about that. Then, when I tried and that failed, I went the next logical route. Keep scouring the internet until I found something that worked. Then I saw the final version of the Roses and Wine mod, which I had to use U-Turret to install it. But here's the thing, the final release only had the original PlayStation 1 soundtrack, which I'm like this. Then the original PlayStation 1 soundtrack of Final Fantasy VIII was awesome. I had no issue with it. I always thought it sounded good. I just realized most of the time it doesn't matter. Oh yeah. Shit. Well, yeah, I definitely used the booster that my GLs could be maxed out. And I find it awesome because grinding that was annoying. That's what, I don't care. Oh, really? Okay. Dude, I don't have time for this. Like, literally, I don't have time. Because if the battle doesn't... Here's what I noticed about this part of the game. If you don't finish the battle before time runs out, and that's even after you defeat the boss, it counts as a game over. I wanted to find the graphics mod, but you know what, I'm okay with what it is. Oh, hey, Ifrit. At least battles don't take that long to load, like PS1. Yeah, I'm about to outright kill you. Yeah, keep running Clistus, it's not gonna matter. The way the limit breaks work in this game is so freaking random. See that X when you're trying to boost? You can press what would essentially be the square button. Then that time, it goes all the way back to the start point. That is not fun. Oh, wow. Alright, murder them. Oh my god, no. No, I do not need this explained. Thank you. I'm glad once you actually get through it, the time limit just stops. Let's see, what is it? No, I'm good. I already got enough gil. Ah, shit, wrong button. That... Yeah, to even use the boosters, really, you have to use the keyboard. Some of the boosters somewhat don't make sense to me. Because I'm not gonna lie, I think Final Fantasy IX's booster was a lot better. But there's one booster that I will never use on Final Fantasy IX, mainly because it is overkill. It's basically max out your character at level 99. But it gives you the maximum magic crystals though. Commentary, I probably would have edited a lot of this out. And the thing is, I'm doing live, so yeah. We'll be right back. conjunction. Is this right? Oh, eventually I gotta remove that card from the door. Really? I think most of y'all know how the MIDI music sounds on the Steam version. I pay attention to the threads, and I think a lot of y'all are like, oh, I'm not gonna buy this until they patch it. And I'm also hearing they did that to the Final Fantasy VII. Which I'm like, really? But they... Oh shit! Oh no. You know what? Run, run, run! Oh shit. I can't escape. Jeez, I can't escape. It must have been up buttons, kind of not set for escape. That's the case. All I gotta say is wow. Yeah, let me take the GF off you. Check something. Okay. No. No, no, no. Oh my god, I just realized something. Escape. The way they got escape is so stupid. After pressing both triggers, that is so dumb. Why would you set escape like this? What makes it so awkward? You gotta hold it like this? What? Just... What? Wow, you didn't give me a chance to, I don't know, go to the menu screen? Yeah, I don't feel like fighting. Like, seriously, I don't. Wait a minute, that's not set right either. What the hell? Menu! It's B3. No. There we go. Ugh. Stop for now, because this is going to be a multi-parter on random play. So next time, I'm gonna go through the seed exam. I'm gonna go through Dulit. Or Dalit, or however the hell you pronounce it. Until then, this is DSJ. See you guys later.